For some of us, this day seems to have taken forever to come. For others, it has come upon us all too quickly. For some, it will be a day filled with the excitement of children, the frantic unwrapping of presents, the wonder at what is new. For others, it will be a day of welcome rest. For some, a day of wonder and joy. For others, it will be a day of poignant remembering of those whose faces we see no more. And for some of us, it will be a mixture of all these things. Whoever you are, and wherever you are this Christmas day, welcome to this worship from Dunblane Cathedral. The song of the angels with the good news of a Saviour's birth is for you. The wonder of the shepherds is for you. The inspiration of the wise men is for you. The coming of the Christ is for you. And I wish you all a very happy and blessed Christmas. Together, let us celebrate the Saviour's birth with the hymn, O Come, All Ye Faithful. People who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in deep shadows, on them light has shined. For to us a child is born, unto us a son is given. Wonderful Counselor, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Let us pray. We welcome you, Jesus, the Child of God, gift of joyfulness in a world that knows tears. We welcome you, Jesus, Child of God, gift of peace in a world that sees too much violence. We welcome you, Jesus, Child of God, into a world that knows despair. We welcome you, Jesus, Child of God, gift of justice, into a world where so much is yet unfair. We welcome you, Jesus, Child of God, gift of love for us all. Let us receive that gift gladly, openly, and with all our heart. As in the words Christ taught us, we say together, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory for ever and ever. Amen. Let us listen for God's word to us this Christmas day, the story of the birth of Christ from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2. In those days, a decree went out from the Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Thank you.
We read again, this time from the Gospel according to St. John, John chapter 1 and from verse 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light which enlightens everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become the children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Amen, and thanks be to God. The run-up to Christmas throws up various challenges, one of which is, for me at least, what does one buy the love of one's life for Christmas? And it can be difficult, especially as in my household, the list of what not to buy is quite a long one. A list that includes chocolate, quite a lot of perfumes, anything that involves wearing wool next to the skin, and anything containing palm oil for ecological reasons, or anything to do with kittens or puppies. Because the love of my life, unlike me, is not a great dog lover. Despite the fact that she derives more pleasure out of choosing a present for the Beadle's dog than all the rest of our Christmas shopping put together. The more irritating the squeak, the better. One other thing I should have on my no list to do with Christmas presents or any present is anything to do with camping. Time spent under canvas is not deemed to be a time of fun. I was told very firmly early in married life, well, if you want to go camping, you can, but you'll be doing so on your own. To be fair, I can see why. Camping, as opposed to glamping, is not the most comfortable of experiences. In a tent, you tend to be vulnerable, in this country to the humble Scottish midge, and in other parts of the world to much more. The only night that Aelia and I ever spent under canvas was in Zambia. And knowing that a leopard was often seen passing through the site that at night concentrated your mind quite wonderfully. Yet when St. John, in his magnificent prologue to his gospel, speaks of the incarnation of God taking human flesh in Christ and being born among us, he uses a word associated with camping. The Word became flesh and pitched his tent among us. Pitched his tent among us. It's a powerful image. In Christ, God is among us, but in a tent. Vulnerable, not remote from where the people are, not in a place of safety or privilege, but alongside them, and moving where they move, going where they go, traveling with them. Where the people have to go, God in Christ will go too. Here is a God who enters the pain of where human beings are, within the shelled, devastated streets of some cities in Ukraine, in the midst of the continuing misery found in Yemen, in the crowded refugee camps in Jordan, Turkey, and Lebanon, within the camps around Calais, where people are so desperate that they will give what money they have left to people who will put them into inadequate dinghies that might get them across the chilly and choppy waters of the English Channel in one last bid for freedom, or which might not. God in Christ pitches his tent among us, full of grace and truth. It is no idle image that the writer of John's Gospel uses when he says that he pitched his tent among us. For elsewhere in the Gospels, such as Matthew, we're told that soon not even the stable can shelter Christ, and parents and child are to be on the run as refugees in Egypt. The Word became flesh and pitched his tent among us, not as some distant spectator watching from a safe distance, but being right there in the midst of all human vulnerability. The prophet's words were spot on. He shall be called Emmanuel, which means God is with us. Amen. Thanks be to God. The hymn, Child in the Manger. As we gather at the table of our Lord, I remind you that this is the table of the Lord, not of any one church, and you are welcome wherever you are, if you wish, to take some bread and some wine and to join in communion at the appropriate point. Let us pray. All praise to you, God, our sunrise, God, our deliverer. All praise to you, Jesus, born in Bethlehem, child of God's faithful promises. When you came to us in him, the old books came alive, words and hints and ancient story leapt off the pages of the past and took shape. The old texts became blood and bone. The time-honored announcements became muscle and flesh. Dormant songs awoke, and the melody they lifted up thrilled the universe. Heaven and earth were fused together, and so now we join the song of our struggle to the triumphant song of eternity, and we lift up to God one adoration. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes who comes to all, who leaves no one unchanged by his coming to them. Life-giving God, as your word became flesh and lived among us, come among us now and show us the fullness of your grace and truth. Make us holy as you are holy, that your word may become flesh and you today. And send your Holy Spirit upon this bread and this wine, that they may be for us the body and blood of Jesus, who at supper with his disciples took bread, gave you thanks, broke the bread and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper he took the cup. Again he gave you thanks and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Drink from this, all of you. This is the blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." God of glory, make your church a sign of newborn hope in your kingdom. Be born in us today, where your children are faced with ruin, show them redemption. Where sorrow endures, bring your holy comfort. Where division excludes, bring your healing grace. Where bondage confines, let there be liberty. To all who are ill, bring healing. To those who are dying, bring reassurance of the life that lies beyond this one. To the people of Ukraine and all who live in the midst of conflict, bring peace. And for those for whom this is a lonely Christmas, let there be reassurance that they are not forgotten. Restore hope throughout this broken world, and bless nurses and care workers whose work is demanding and tough, and whose struggle to make ends meet sometimes undermines their sense of worth. Bless members of all our emergency services and our armed forces, upon whose commitment and professionalism our nation depends. And be with all those whose work this Christmas separates them from family and friends. Comfort all for whom an empty seat at the table brings sorrow and regret. And let the day come when all you have brought into being finds its everlasting destiny in the glory of your Son, Jesus Christ, when nothing in heaven or on earth falls outside your redeeming purpose, and all things shall be full of grace and truth through you, one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. When at supper with his disciples, Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And after supper he took the cup, and again he gave you thanks and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Drink from this, all of you. This is the blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." These are the gifts of God for all the people of God. Wherever you are, you're invited to take some bread and some wine and to share in this feast. And let the peace and goodwill of which the angels sang, the peace of the Christ child, be with you and all you remember and love. Amen. Our closing hymn, "Hark, the Herald Angels Sing."
Oh.
Word became flesh and dwelt among us, pitched his tent in the midst of us. Go in the confidence that God is with us, and may the blessing of God, the wise eternal Father, the Christ child born for us, the Spirit given for our life, be with you and all you love, now and always.